You never leave your partner, especially in a fire.
Yes, sir.
Hey, Mama. How are you, huh? It's been so long since I heard your voice.
Are you planning on making a grocery trip soon?
You work 24 hours and then you're off for 48. You've got more time to go than I do.
You could at least save me some breakfast.
I never know when you're coming home or going out. You don't tell me these things.
Catherine, what is your problem? Did I offend you by walking in the door?
Just can't expect me to work every day and still get the groceries while you sit at home looking at trash on the internet.
You chose to take this job.
We need the income. You've got $24,000 in savings, but we have things in our house that need fixing.
I've been saving up for my boat for years. You're not taking that from me.
How is it that I get respect everywhere I go except in my own house?
A woman's like a rose. If you treat her right, she'll bloom.
Did you leave me any dinner at all?
I assumed you were eating with Michael.
Does it not occur to you that there are two people living in this house and—
If you would communicate with me, maybe I could have something for you.
Why do you have to make everything so difficult?
Seems to me like I'm the one carrying the weight around here while you're off doing your own thing.
Excuse me?
Caleb, who takes care of this house? Who washes all the clothes? Who gets all the groceries? Not to mention I'm helping my parents every weekend. I've got all this pressure on me, and the only thing you ever do for anybody is for yourself.
You don't know the first thing about pressure, right? You think I put out house fires for myself? Or pull a child's body out of a lake for myself?
Oh, yeah, but what do you do around here other than watch TV and waste time on the internet? You care more about saving for your stupid boat and pleasing yourself than—
Shut up! You disrespectful, ungrateful, selfish woman! You constantly nag me and you drain the life out of me!
I want out. I just want out.
That's fine with me!
Oh, so now it's a hot date.
Life's too short to have any other kind.
Again! Again! One, two, three!
Thank you, Lord.
If I'm not here helping wash the dishes, I'm a horrible husband.
But she can't do everything around here.
Now you sound like you're taking her side.
Dad, why did you have to bring her? You're a mother. No one loves you more than her.
She's still trying to fix me. I'm not broken.
Dad, I'm glad you didn't split up. But I would have understood if you had.
Do you know why we didn't?
Not really.
Caleb, the Lord did a work in us.
If there's a God out there somewhere, Dad, he's not interested in me and my problems.
I disagree. I'd say he's very interested.
Then where's he been in my life?
I'd say he's been at work all around you. You just haven't realized it. Is there anything in you that wants to save your marriage?
And she wants divorce.
Is that what you want?
I want peace.
Caleb, I want you to do something for me. I want you to hold off on the divorce for 40 days. I'm going to send you something in the mail, something that'll take you that long to do.
What is it?
It's what saved our marriage. Take one day at a time. I'm asking as your father.
40 days?
40 days.
Divorce is a hard thing, man.
Well, if it brings peace.
You want the right kind of peace.
What do you mean by that?
When most people promise for better or for worse, they really only mean for the better.
But marriages aren't fireproof. Sometimes you get burned.
Fireproof doesn't mean that a fire will never come, but that when it comes, you'll be able to withstand it.
Day one. For the next day, resolve to say nothing negative to your spouse at all. Be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to get angry. James 1:19.
Would you have time to take that to the dry cleaners today?
I think after 2 days off, you would have already taken care of that.
Day two, do at least one unexpected gesture as an act of kindness.
Poured your coffee.
I don't have time for coffee.
Day three, buy your wife something that says you were thinking of her today.
I need to order some flowers or something for my wife. I wanted to call and check on you.
You called to see if I needed anything.
I'm fine.
All right, well, goodbye.
Day four.
You know why your sweet little gestures mean nothing to me? It's because that's the kind of man you've become.
She has completely rejected all of it.
Caleb, this process takes 40 days, not four.
Caleb, you're not a quitter. It's a slow thing. When
it's a slow thing.
What are you doing?
Maybe I'd like to have dinner with my wife.
I do not love you.
Catherine's not buying any of it. Because she doesn't love me. I need Catherine to wake up to the fact that we're about to get an ugly divorce. I'm trying to prevent that, but I cannot do it by myself.
I think you need more than that.
Dad, if you're gonna tell me I need Jesus, please don't.
He's become the most significant part of our lives.
How is that?
I realized my need for him. I needed his forgiveness and salvation.
Why do I need his salvation? What, am I gonna be thrown into hell because I got divorced?
No, because you violated his standards.
Dad, I help people. I am a good person.
According to you, God doesn't judge by your standards. He uses his. His standards are so high, he considers hatred to be murder, lust to be adultery.
What about all the good I've done?
You've broken his commandments, and one day you'll answer to him for that. If I were to ask you why you're so frustrated with Catherine, what would you say?
She's stubborn. She's ungrateful.
I have tried to demonstrate that I still care about this relationship. How am I supposed to show love to somebody over and over who constantly rejects me?
That's a good question. Caleb, the answer is, you can't love her because you can't give her what you don't have. I couldn't truly love your mother until I understood what love really was. It's not because I get some reward out of it. I've now made a decision to love your mother whether she deserves it or not. God loves you even though you don't deserve it. Even though you've rejected him. Jesus Christ changed my life. I can't settle this for you. This is between you and the Lord. Can't you see that you need him? Can't you see that you need his forgiveness?
Yes. How did you get off to such a good start with Tina? I mean, why is it so easy for you?
You gotta beg God to teach you how to be a good husband. And don't just follow your heart, man, because your heart can be deceived.
No, Mom's not doing too well.
What does your mom need?
A better wheelchair and hospital bed would be at the top of the list.
Well, he sustained some first-degree burns here, but he should be fine. So this is your husband?
Yes.
Looks like you've got a hero on your hands.
Day 23. Watch out for parasites. They're usually in the form of addictions like gambling, drugs, or pornography. And consume more and more of your thoughts, time, and money.
To come by and talk to you about some of the equipment that we've been looking at.
Oh, the bed and wheelchair we delivered to your parents this morning.
But I haven't paid for anything yet.
It's actually already been paid for. A gentleman called and said that he wanted to pay for everything that you had picked out. Mrs. Holt?
Gavin, you didn't have to do that.
Do what?
Giving money to help my parents. Thank you.
You're welcome. Sick?
I'll be fine.
You got a fever. Here.
Why are you doing this?
I have learned you never leave your partner, especially in a fire.
I'm not ready to say that I trust you again.
I am sorry. I have been so selfish. I have loved other things when I should have loved you. In the last few weeks, God has given me a love for you that I have never had before. And I have asked him to forgive me. I am praying that somehow you would be able to forgive me too. Catherine, I do not want to live the rest of my life without you.
I need some time. I just need to pick up a few linens for the hospital bed for my mom.
We have some in stock.
That's about the only thing that wasn't covered by the doctor when he purchased that bed and wheelchair.
The doctor?
Dr. Keller, our secret philanthropist.
$24,300 was given for the bed and wheelchair. Dr. Keller gave $300.
Then who gave the other?
Your husband, Caleb. He came in about 2 weeks ago and paid for everything.
2 weeks ago?
Catherine?
If I haven't told you that you are a good man, you are. And if I haven't told you
that I've forgiven you. I have. And if I haven't told you that I love you, I do. Something has changed in you, Caleb. And I want what happened to you to happen to me.
I want to thank you, Dad.
God changed your life.
I just can't tell you how grateful I am that you didn't give up on me, Dad. Or on Mom, for that matter.
I wrote that notebook in my own handwriting, but I didn't do the love day on your mom. She did it to me. I was the one that wanted to leave. But God got a hold of your mother. It was through her example that I came to Christ.
I have treated her so wrong. Mom, I'm so sorry.
It's all right, son. It's okay.